I had one question for you, and it's legitimately a question. I'm not really so much coming for a quote-unquote debate, but I watched on First Take, and you made the point that the ultimate resolution of the situation with Wallace would have a – it would be an impediment to race relations. Did I get that right?
That's right.
Okay, I'm just curious. Like, what do you think is the biggest impediment to race relations in America?
I think the biggest impediment to race relations – you're probably not going to like my answer. For some reason, it falls hollow on so many ears and hearts. Is that human beings, I think we've had this conversation before, Bomani, have trouble seeing each other as individuals, seeing each other for who we are as human beings. I mean, man to man, woman to woman, man to woman, not as members of any given group, political cause, race, gender, sexuality, whatever it may be. It's a difficult thing for human beings. People accomplish it at different levels. We are inherently tribal, and our job is to overcome those tribes and see each other as individuals. I believe when we do this, it will make it harder for people to look inward and see, do I fail? Am I failing in my ability to look at others as individuals? Instead, it will continuously be this external focused thing. Is that racist? Is this racist? Is that improvement? Is this not improvement? And it will undercut not just anybody's external indictments. It will also undercut anybody's willingness to look inward.
All right, so let's try this. If I were to ask you in 1865, what is the greatest impediment to race relations in America, what would you have said? Would you have said the whole thing about tribalism and everything else?
No, it would have been, yes, at a deeper philosophical level, but the more immediate biggest impediment at that point would have been the institution of slavery.
Right, but the issue is really the impediment to racism is white people not treating black people as being of equal levels of humanity. Like, that's the answer for all of the time. Like, the reason I wanted to call in, it's very important to note this, especially considering the power dynamics. Me viewing you, for example, through the lens of just being a part of a group and not an individual doesn't have any negative effect on your life. You viewing others the other way actually does have a negative effect in their lives. Like, it's not the same thing. We can't do the both sides, and human beings are just like this, because there's been a level of subjugation to people in this country that is uncommon and is not something that we can look at all across the world and thereby ascribe all this necessarily to tribalism. The problem I have is when you say that what happened with Bubba Wallace is going to be an impediment to race relations. Nah, man, those people rolling on Speedway Boulevard before that race with those flags flying, those are an impediment to race relations. The person that had a flag, had a thing that said defund NASCAR on Sunday over the track, that's the impediment to race relations. I found myself, actually, when the thing happened with the garage, not even really so much talking about that, because the other things that were going on, those are far bigger impediments. And if anybody is to look at that situation, and I disagree with you about NASCAR. NASCAR did exactly what they should have done. If I were to walk up to your house and if the cops saw somebody kicked in your back door, the cops are going to come in, and if they see your house has been tossed around, they're going to think that you got robbed. If they ultimately look around and find out that nobody took any of your stuff, then they're going to say, okay, you didn't get robbed. But nobody's going to tell you, if you walk into your house and it's all torn up, that you didn't get robbed. Nobody's going to do that. And in this case, it's the same exact thing. If you're a black, if you're a black driver and somebody saw something that appeared to be a noose, right, you got to call the FBI immediately. Because if you don't call it, and I'm Bubba Wallace, we got a big old problem if somebody thought there was a noose and you guys didn't look into it fully. I applaud NASCAR for actually going and checking it out. They investigated it. The next day, nothing was the case, apparently, from what they have said. No person was accused. No person was castigated for it. And then you keep on going. But you can't tell people not to overreact when you see what you think is a noose, and then justify people overreacting on the back end to the idea that it did not go the way it appeared to have.
If all that NASCAR did was call for an investigation and call the FBI, I think you would be right. But that is not all that NASCAR did. NASCAR put out an affirmative statement saying that a heinous hate crime had taken place. That drove the news cycle. Every headline and every conversation from that point forward was based on the assumption that an affirmative act had taken place. If the cops walked into your house and noticed some stuff missing, they do not say automatically that you have been robbed and then go look for the culprit. They first say this: some stuff is missing. Was there a robbery? NASCAR didn't offer us the ability to have that conversation, or it allowed everybody to move forward with the idea that there had already been a robbery. That's NASCAR's mistake. It took the FBI and their investigation to undo that.
Yeah, but be fair to NASCAR on this one. Like, really, you have to. This was not an implausible conclusion if somebody reached it. The odds of this not being what they thought it was based on what they apparently had before them seemed to be fairly low, right? If they got that wrong, okay, they got that wrong. But I feel like in the way that you are approaching this, you are giving cover to the people who then see this, and I know you don't believe that this was a hoax because it's not, right? But you give cover to the whole, hey, this is a hoax, people, and, you know, every time there's, you know, like, if there's so much racism, why do people have to make it up and so forth and so on? You delegitimize what is actually going on in so many people's lives, what we see everywhere, and what we saw before the race. So, like, if we got a real problem with something, NASCAR allowing that flag to be what it was for so long is a much bigger problem than them mishandling this. I don't get the feeling that you was charged up about that, and that doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me.
Bo, I feel very passionately about this fact. I am not the one undercutting the idea of people's ability to accept that racism takes place or individual instances. False claims like this undercut that. That is what empowers those who think that things are hoaxes. This is what, do you think they're more or less empowered today, Bo?
Let me tell you what empowers those people. Racism is what empowers those people. The idea, because what you got to realize is, if this had been real and then the next one is fake, they still going to jump on the fake one and ignore the real one. We have so many examples of actual real live, real things like this that have happened throughout American history, recent and farther back, that if you want to talk about it, those things are there. As soon as there's one hoax, the people jump up and be like, oh, see, that's what it is, because that's what those people were going to do no matter what. So to simply point out that now we got people on the back end and that's going to be an impediment to racism, those people are much more of an impediment to racism than anything that happens on the back end. I don't see you calling these people the impediment. Are we saying that the dude flying the flag over the track, do you think that's an impediment to race relations? Because I absolutely think that it is. That actually got far too little discussion around this, that NASCAR decided that they were going to make these changes, and you had fans who were deciding, no, this is our space to do this, and they ride around the track before the race, and they fly the banner overhead. Like, that is an overt act of racism, and we should applaud NASCAR for the fact that they, for the first time ever, are standing up to those people. Instead, you're going to say that NASCAR failed by investigating what they believed to be a noose in the garage of the black driver? Come on, man.
I'm not saying NASCAR failed because they investigated. I'm saying NASCAR failed because they gave an affirmative statement before the investigation.
Okay,
and the news cycle was driven.
I'm just saying this to you right now. If somebody were to hang a noose around my desk or something that looked like a noose near my desk and you saw it at the office and you came up to me and were like, well, hold on.
I don't think. You said it was very plausible.
Let's get to the bottom of it. Whoo, baby, me and you going to have a problem. And if you got a problem with that, then I think that you're being unfair to people for quacking. That thing is flapping. That thing is walking.
No.
Let's see if it's a duck. It just so happened this time it wasn't a duck.
Bo, I totally disagree with you about your probabilities you describe as well. The probabilities that a garage door pull tied into a certain knot was a noose versus a looking around with video evidence, NASCAR could have taken its time and gotten this right. And by the way, it wouldn't have taken much time. Video evidence, a quick survey of the landscape, realizing that there are pictures all over the place of showing this thing goes back to October. I don't think NASCAR's assumptions and probabilities were fair at all.
I think it was more important to stand with that dude in that time
and with the
evidence that they had before them and what that appeared to be. I don't think that there was really anything wrong with the affirmative statement they put out, because here's the thing, if they don't put out an affirmative statement, what it fairly looks like in that case is that they are trying to downplay this. No, what they saw needed to be treated, I think, with the level of urgency that they pursued it with. No individual has paid any price for this. The only people who seem to be mad about this are people who think that there's something insulting about the idea that maybe, just maybe, after all the history in this country, maybe, just maybe, somebody white did something really ridiculously racist, as though that's some sort of anomalous activity. It's not. And white folks got to live with the fact that you're asking for a benefit of the doubt that is not supported by the historical record.
That is such a broad sweeping indictment of an entire race of people in this country that is
It's a sweeping indictment of the history of this country.
No.
Newspapers of the day come back to support.
when you say the benefit of the doubt, that is something that is earned by individuals, Bo. I want to respond to what you said. I want to make a statement.
You're wrong there, and that's the biggest problem
with
all
well,
of this stuff.
That's just that's basically where we disagree. I believe in individualism and agency. I believe it at the core of my being, and I think it's what solves the problems in this country.
I know you believe that, but in application, white people receive the benefit of the doubt blanketly as a group of people in the face of circumstances that nobody else can ever receive. That's why when people actually get caught doing something racist and they give some, oh, my bad, apology, and everybody's like, oh, well, he apologized, moved on, I'm sure he turned into a different person. It's because of a broad benefit of the doubt that white people receive in this country that other people do not get. And I'm sorry. There is not enough here to say that it is unfair if someone truly believed they saw something fashioned as a noose, and what apparently from the descriptions of Bubba Wallace and others, what it looked like in that garage on that rope is not what it looked like in the other garages. It's just not. There appears to be a difference there. Like, I'm not here to believe that people just are really like, yo, hurry up and call the FBI. Don't nobody want to do that. They don't. But broadly speaking, the idea that somebody could put a noose in Bubba Wallace's stall, it's not close to being out of the realm of possibility. It's not even there. And again, you seem more bothered by the fact that somebody got this wrong than you were with this display of defiance that took place before the race with the racist trying to assert that NASCAR is theirs when NASCAR is like, yo, could you please chill out? That's not what we want to do no more.
All right, I'd like to respond to that. I hope you'll let me respond to that here on the Will Cain Show. We only have a minute or so left. I appreciate you wanting to interact with me today. It's the first time we've ever, I think, not ever, the few times on air interacted. I believe this. I believe there are terrible people in this world. There are racist people in this world. Do I believe they showed up at NASCAR races and flew flags? I do believe that, and I think they always will be, and I think that it are. Those people, as you pointed out, will probably always exist, and this evidence is meaningless to them. Their racism is core to who they are. But I believe that human beings out there that can be won over, that are truly persuadable people, who realize that if I look internally and improve my own individual life, don't qualify my virtue by yelling racist at other people, but live a life of action and as a good human being, they can be persuaded. But, and this gets to my outrage now, but if you undercut the truth consistently, this is an example, there are others, and you say, what have you made a big deal about this, Will, on, you know, the other examples, whether or not it's the circle game or a child's tweets who goes on to be a professional athlete. When you take a moment like this and you such cavalier disregard for the truth, what you do is you lose those persuadable people who will stop looking inward individually, and that's why, to take this conversation full circle, I believe you do this country a disservice and you take a step backwards.
And if those people can be dissuaded that easily by that one mistake, they're not nearly as persuadable as you're giving them credit for being, which is you.
Or that's how important I think the truth is. Or it's just how important
the doubt.
Or it's just important. It just shows how important I believe the truth is.
Well, I mean, the one thing I do think, though, the truth in this is very important. I think there's something to it. What gets frustrating often, like, in hearing you talk about this is, somehow you'd be the only one that's speaking the truth, right? Like, you're the only dude that's, everybody else is falling for it, right? Everybody else is out here on some okey-doke when it comes to this, but you, seeker of truth in this matter, we got the truth now, right? And so I can see, people may have gotten it wrong in a very sensitive time. They put a two and two together that did not happen to be four. But I think that's far more reasonable than you give it credit for being, and you give way more credit to these people who then on the back end will then say, well, I don't care about these things anymore, rather than chastise them for the fact that they never gave a damn in the first place.
All right. I appreciate the interaction. Bomani Jones.